Hi everyone, welcome to the Summer Garden Tour. Now it's been a couple months since I've done a tour of my garden, so I thought I would take you around and show you how things are growing since the last time we did a tour. Let's go. I want to start right up here on my deck with my tomato plant here. You might remember this from the Growing Your Indoor Garden series. This is my tomato plant that I grew indoors all winter long and then moved outside here on my deck. And oh my gosh, look at this. It is just bursting with tomatoes. It's grown so much and I'm really, really pleased with how it made the transition from indoors to outdoors. Now a lot of people said that this tomato wouldn't make the transition, but it's growing absolutely beautiful and I have a lot of cherry tomatoes to pick. And this is a Chadwick cherry tomato. Great tomato to grow in a container. Now I really love growing things right outside my kitchen door. My kitchen door is just right here. So I've got my tomatoes, I've got my basil and some herbs in this nice little container here. Some oregano, basil, rosemary, so I can just pop out here whenever I'm cooking and just pick some of this and take it inside to cook for a meal. Now in case you're not familiar with my garden, our house is on a hill and a lot of the main part of my garden here is on this slope, which we've terraced out and then filled in with plants depending on the season. Now right here in the top bed I've got some tomato plants. Now these tomato plants are struggling just a little bit because they've gotten shaded by a big tree that's right overhead. We've trimmed that tree back, it's getting a little more sun now, so I'm hoping for some more growth out of these tomatoes. This tomato here is actually a Kellogg's breakfast tomato, but again, it's been shaded most of the summer, not getting any production out of it right now, but I'm hoping to soon. This tomato is called a Brad's Atomic Grape Tomato, and I do have some small tomatoes on that one, which I'm looking forward to harvesting. And this one here is called a Chocolate Sprinkles. Now, this is a really fun tomato. It's kind of a smaller tomato, kind of striped, and absolutely delicious. We've been harvesting a little bit off of that plant. And this one here is called a Dancing with Smurfs, at least I think it is. And from what I thought, it was supposed to be a smaller size tomato, but if you can see right here, it's actually a large one, and I'm thinking I might have got the variety mixed up. I'm kind of hoping it turns into a Kellogg's breakfast, but we'll see what happens with that. So that's basically what I'm growing in this garden bed. I've also got some kale that's kind of bolting, and some basil, some beautiful purple basil down here. Now I absolutely love purple basil. It's a very beautiful, beautiful plant, as you can see. Makes a really nice color splash in the garden. And I'm definitely hoping that these tomatoes will take off now that they've got some more sun. So let's go on down here. Come on down with me and we'll take a look at some of the other fun tomatoes that I'm growing. These tomato plants right here are some of my favorite that I'm growing so far this season. This one is an absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous tomato. It's called a Lucid Gem. And look at the color on that. Isn't that absolutely beautiful? It's got a purple, a red, color down here, and I'm waiting to harvest my very first one, but I absolutely love this plant. I mean, look how it changes colors as it goes from just that first blush to this one is pretty much just about ripe. I absolutely love it. Now, I wanted to show you here is that we've had some rodent issues in our garden, and what I'm doing to help protect it from rodents, besides putting traps out, is covering my tomatoes with this like t-shirt material here. So I just cut off old pieces of a t-shirt or pieces of an old t-shirt and wrap it around the tomato plant. And I had this plant almost completely wrapped, all of the tomatoes. I took some of them off to show you, but this really does seem to help keep the rodents away. So I'm hoping for the best with this plant and hopefully I get a really good harvest. Now, the tomato plant next door to it is absolutely beautiful. You might have seen these two tomatoes in a recent video we did, a 2-minute tip video, but this is a pink Berkeley tie-dye, and oh my goodness, look at those colors. This is a huge beefsteak tomato, super sweet, super juicy. Now, right behind me is this fence, as you see, and what I really like to do is plant flowers all along the fence to help keep the weeds down, to help bring in the pollinators, and some of my favorite flowers are zinnias. So I've got this beautiful, here's one, a peppermint stick zinnia, and absolutely gorgeous. So I'm really loving the different varieties of zinnias this season that I've got going. And right behind it is this beautiful lime zinnia, it's called. Now, if you follow me and walk over this way, I have one of my favorite tomato plants right in over here that I actually just put in about a month ago. This is a Kellogg's breakfast tomato. And it's an absolutely beautiful big beefsteak orange tomato. And I've got some flowers coming on right here, so I'm super excited to hopefully get some tomatoes from this plant. But this was a late summer planting, so hopefully we'll get a harvest in the fall. So let's turn around here and take a look at one of my current favorite flowers. I mean, look at this zinnia. Is this one of the most beautiful flowers you've ever seen? This is a giant zinnia and just an absolutely gorgeous pink color. It just bloomed a couple of days ago and I posted a picture on Instagram, but I absolutely love this flower. I mean, actually it matches my shirt, so that's kind of fun. But don't be afraid to integrate flowers with your vegetables. It makes a really nice color splash in the garden. And I actually did a late summer planting of some zinnias right down in here. Actually started these indoors just to get them going fast. Popped them in the ground this week, and that will I'll have zinnias well into the fall. So this is a mystery tomato. I don't know, have any idea what it was when I planted it, but it's looking like it's coming on either as a chocolate sprinkles or as an atomic grape tomato. So we'll have to see, but it's nice little clusters. I just think it looks really pretty how it's grown there in clusters. More flowers coming on, so hoping for more harvest of that very soon. Now right here behind me is actually my $10 garden. If you watch the $10 garden series, this is where I planted everything from that series. I've got a, right behind here, I'll show you this back part first, some beans. Now these beans were getting eaten alive by spider mites. I actually went and trimmed these back. I trimmed off most of the damaged foliage, sprayed it with peppermint spray, gave it a good fertilizer, the Revive RX and my gardener, the Vermisteria worm tea. I'm seeing a lot of new growth, some new flowers here, and I'm really glad I didn't pull these plants out because I think they're gonna come back. And here we've got some Market More cucumbers. Again, my cucumbers have kind of struggled this season with spider mites, so these have also been sprayed with peppermint oil, trimmed back, and I am seeing some new growth here at the top. Right in here, some new flowers, a couple new cucumbers forming. So these same thing have been sprayed and fertilized, and I really think they're gonna come back. We also have some basil in here, which we'll be doing a harvesting basil video very soon. This California Wonder Pepper, oh, you guys have got to see this. We've gotta go around the other side because these are absolutely stunners. Look at these peppers. You guys have gotta get a good look at this. They are humongous. Beautiful, nice, really thick walled peppers. I mean, these would be perfect stuffing peppers, but this plant has got several on here. This one looks like it's ready to harvest. We'll probably be harvesting that several later on. And it's got about five or six peppers on it. Oh my gosh, I didn't even see these. These are green, but they're gonna turn a beautiful orange color. So you can really harvest peppers at any stage, but I like to wait till they're red. And this Roma tomato plant is absolutely loaded down. I've already picked a couple freezer bags full, put them in my freezer. Beautiful, nice Roma tomato for sauces and salsas and just for fresh eating. Okay, so let's go take a look and see what we missed as we were coming down one side of the hill. Okay, right here, let me come around the other side here. Right here, I've got a couple tomatillo plants. Now, typically tomatillos grow very, very fast. These were shaded out by a big borage plant, which I just took out. So I'm hoping for some more growth on those, but they're actually a purple tomatillo. Oh, I see one. I haven't even noticed this yet, but it's starting to form. You can see right here, this is my first tomatillo of the season right there. So these are absolutely beautiful in salsa verde. Since they're purple tomatillos, it might not be salsa verde. And right next to these plants, you can see it's kind of a challenge sometimes to get back in here because of the hill. But this is another Roma, starting to get the first blush on those. Here we have a Thai basil plant. Actually, I'm not sure if it's Thai basil, but it looks like Thai basil. And I let this one go to seed because the bees really love the flowers. And it's nice to keep all the bees around that I possibly can. Another thing I wanted to mention is that with some of my flowers here, I'm letting them dry up and go to seed. And that way they drop their seeds all along this fence line here. And hopefully I continually have flowers growing throughout the fall. Sometimes even the winter time, it's warm enough to grow these flowers here in Southern California. I'm pretty thrilled with this tomato area of my garden. Very prolific tomatoes. This is a, I think it's a yellow boy tomato or something like that, but absolutely beautiful. Look at that color, those tomatoes, kind of a medium sized. And then next to it, I have two yellow pears. Now, if you have never grown yellow pears, I'm telling you, you have got to get these in your garden. Super prolific. I mean, look at how loaded down these plants are. These are like candy. Absolutely delicious. I'm going to be harvesting these and bringing some of these to the neighbors today. But oh my goodness. We pick these by the handfuls and eat them like candy in our house. They're great for snacks. Mmm. So sweet, absolutely delicious. Love these tomatoes. Can't say enough good about them. Next right here is an organic tomato. I think that's called a cherry husky. Something like that. These are great snacking tomatoes as well. And this plant is also super prolific, definitely earning a permanent spot in my garden. Mmm. Garden snacks are the best. One way I'm really excited to be able to expand my growing space is through my Smart Pots container garden. So hopefully you watch the Grow Large Veggies in Container series, but that's all of these veggies here on the front row, some tomatoes, really beautiful Black Beauty eggplant right here. Got a really nice one underneath. A couple little new ones coming on, and I think we're gonna have a lot from this plant. There's some little tiny ones starting to develop right over here. It's so much fun to see the little small vegetables start to come on in the garden. It's always a lot of fun, but that plant is loaded with flowers. The zucchini is doing great. I've actually been pruning it back. It's a few leaves I need to prune back still that are kind of bug damaged, but that happens on zucchini leaves. And some really nice looking zucchini down underneath there. Some new flowers. So this vegetable has been very, very productive for me this summer so far. So let me give you a little tour of the rest of the Smart Pots garden. Here I've got just a variety of greens growing, some kale, some chard, really nice little basil plant. I believe that one's called Pesto Party. It's a small, more compact variety of basil. Sweet basil, absolutely delicious. And then moving on over here to this tomato plant, this is another Brad's Atomic Grape Tomato. And you can see the beautiful different colors here on this tomato as it ripens. It starts off first, these little purple striped tomatoes, and then these are just about ripe. I can probably harvest these today. We can take them inside and have them for breakfast. But really a pretty little plant, really enjoying that. And come on back over here. This is the salsa garden. Now, one reason I love this is because of this purple Smart Pots. I love the color, and I just love the color of the different peppers as they're starting to come on. These little purple pepper flowers are absolutely beautiful. I think they're just so pretty, and you can see the little peppers starting to develop here. A few little onions in here to go along with my salsa. And this little hot pepper plant is just starting to produce. Look at all these teeny tiny hot peppers. I'm not sure where the tag is, not sure what varieties this is, but I've got hot peppers. I've got your classic cherry Chadwick tomato. Love this tomato, it's a very good producer. Lots of green tomatoes, some red tomatoes starting to ripen up. But this plant is just getting taller and taller. I had to stake it up with an 8-foot pole here in addition to the large tomato cage. And then around on this side, I've got some sweet peppers. This is my favorite, Jimmy Nardello. Love those on the grill, absolutely delicious. And a really nice, big pepper is the Golden Marconi. I mean, look at that color, isn't that beautiful? And this plant doesn't have a lot of peppers on it yet, but hopefully with the warm weather we're having, it'll get nice and loaded down. Now the watermelon are one of my favorite things to grow, and the compact varieties are doing very well for me this season. This is a sugar baby. Yep, these are sugar babies. You can see my little watermelon slings here. And one thing about these plants is I pruned it back very hard a few weeks ago. It had some disease on it, little spots and things like that. So I cut a ton of leaves off. I gave it some of MI Gardener's RX, his new fertilizer he has, Vermistera Worm Tea. And would you look at all this new growth? This is just in about 2 weeks. All the blooms, there's just a ton of more blooms on here, and I know I'm gonna get a couple more harvests off of these two Smart Pots. I have one right behind me, Same situation, already have new melons growing right over here. This one just popped out in the past probably a couple weeks or so. So loving the compact watermelon. Now behind me here, I've got a cattle panel garden arch trellis. If you've never grown on a cattle panel, great way to grow vertically, super, super sturdy. And the fun thing about this is you can cover it in the wintertime and make like a little greenhouse. So in here right now, I've got some butternut squash on the trellising up over the top. And let's see, here's one that I just think looks so pretty hanging down. But yeah, it's just absolutely gorgeous. There's several butternuts in here. This one is actually getting pretty close to harvest. The stem is getting kind of hard and brown, and we could be harvesting that one before too much longer. Then in the middle here, I've got some patty pan squash, some zucchini, and this was actually completely aphid infested this week. I had to come in here and spray it off with water, do the peppermint oil, the whole thing you saw the video on this week. But it is looking good, it's totally bouncing back, and I know I'll get a lot more production out of this. One thing I am so excited about this summer is the veggie pod. If you haven't watched any of the veggie pod videos, this is a self-watering raised bed with a cover that protects from pests. And oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this lettuce. It is just doing absolutely beautifully, even in the 90 degree heat. I have several different varieties with different colors. I've never been able to grow lettuce like this before. Now some of this in here is starting to bolt. This is a black seeded Simpson, which is typically very heat tolerant, but it has been over 90 degrees, so it's done very, very well. I did go ahead and plant some other warm weather vegetables in here, some green beans and some cucumbers over on this side, but the cucumbers are looking great. In other areas of my garden, they're really damaged by spider mites and leaf miners. There's just a teeny tiny bit of leaf miner damage here, but the cover is really protecting it. Now, one thing I'm really excited about too is this dill that's just coming up right here. Now, usually dill is a cool weather vegetable, but the shade cover is giving it enough of the sunblock that's allowed the dill and some cilantro right next to it to germinate. Now, this area here is really the focal point of our backyard. Got the fountain in the middle and a planter around the edges where I've actually pretty much have most of my peppers. On this side over here, I've got sweet peppers. Now, I love growing peppers. I love the color splash that they make in the garden. And I've got a whole bunch of sweet peppers along this row over here. Not sure quite what all the varieties are. I think this is a sweet banana. Multicolored bell pepper. I forget all the varieties. Oh, this is my favorite, Jimmy Nardello. I mean, look at this. It's loaded down. This is a beautiful sweet pepper, delicious on the grill. That charred grilled flavor just brings out the sweetness. This is some kind of a pumpkin looking pepper. I forget the name of it. And this is a black Hungarian pepper. Yellow banana, this one's quite prolific. And what I tried to do in here too is plant some trailing plants. This is some kind of a squash. I thought it was a spaghetti squash, but I'm not sure. That's gonna trail along the inside. So I'm really trying to maximize every little bit of space here that I can. And over on the other side, I've got some hot peppers. Now look at these really adorable looking yellow peppers. This is actually called a sunshine chili. One of my viewers in India sent me these seeds. So I'm really, really proud to be growing these and honored that she would send me the seeds to grow in my garden. I think it's gonna be a really prolific pepper, and I'm sure it's gonna be super, super hot. This is also a Thai chili, which is another seed that she sent to me. So really excited to be growing those. And I've got a bunch of hot peppers in here. Now you can see I'm gonna be loaded down here. I'm gonna have to make a lot of pepper jelly to use all these. Right here we've got another cattle panel trellis. And this, I planted some larger sized watermelon, and for some reason they're just not doing very well. I've got one kind of trailing up the back of the trellis here, but I pulled some out because they were getting diseased. Not too sure why they're stunted this season. Maybe they just got off to a bad start and never recovered. So I went ahead and did a second planting in here. Got some squash going, and this week I just planted some cucumbers. So I'm hoping that these will trail up over the trellis over the fall. And then, of course, my favorite flower I've got in here is a sunflower. This one's kind of reaching the end of its days, but I absolutely love sunflowers, so I try and plant them wherever I can in my garden. What I would suggest too is trying to succession plant. So I've just put new plants in. That way when the summer plants die out, there'll be plants there that will take its place, and hopefully I'll have a harvest well into the fall and even into the winter time. Now just outside my trellis right here, I used to have a little lemon tree. It was right there where I'm pointing. Some of you have asked about it, and it bit the dust, so we had a nice little funeral for it, said goodbye, but that's okay, because that happens in the garden. Things die, things don't make it, no big deal. You just move on. The grapes. So this grapevine has been in the ground about 3 years. Haven't had a harvest. This is the very first year we've had a harvest, and I have to admit to you guys, I really have not done anything to these grapes. They've been a bit neglected. Didn't even prune them back over the winter, as I should have. Just got busy with other things. And what is happening though is I've got grapes. I'm so excited about these grapes. I mean, these are absolutely gorgeous. In fact, I actually picked one the other day to try it out. It tastes like a real grape.
Wow, I can't believe you're eating a grape.
It's amazing. A grape from our own backyard. Can you believe it?
We had no clue what we were
doing. I know. I still don't really know what I'm doing with grapes, but the cool thing is that I've got some clusters on here, and we will definitely be doing a harvest video very, very soon, because look at these. These are ready. These are ready. So I wouldn't say the plant is loaded down, but I definitely have grapes, and next year with proper pruning, I'm hoping to show you a plant that's absolutely loaded with grapes. Now this is one of my very favorite areas of the garden, and I call this the red planter area. One reason is because of the strawberry crate towers. I love the strawberry crate towers. They've been such a fun project, and got lots of blooms coming on. It's been super hot here, as I keep mentioning. I've actually been keeping them shaded. Let me show you the shade cloth that I use to cover them with during the heat of the day. I just leave this kind of clipped onto the back of the tower. Just cover it over, and this is a 40% shade block, so they still do get some sun. Strawberries do best when it's 85 degrees or cooler. Once it gets over 85, they really don't like to produce. But just using this simple shade cloth has been giving me a little handful of berries every day. Here in this red planter area, I did the garden workday video a while back. And if you watch that video, you can see what a difference it is now. I planted some edible vegetation in here, and it's looking nice. I'm really happy with how it's growing in. Here's the star of the eggplant harvest video. Got more ping tongue eggplant coming on. It's a really nice, small, thin, and skinny Japanese eggplant. So these are about ready to harvest. They're nice and shiny, which is a good sign. Got some herbs going on here, some oregano. Now I've kind of just let this grow because the bees love it. They buzz around, and it's always great to see the pollinators. So right here is a celery tree. I removed several of these on the garden workday video, but I leave this one in because I think it looks kind of cool. I mean, who's ever seen a celery tree? I can't believe how big this has grown. So the seeds just drop, and this celery grows back every single year. But the bees also do love the celery flowers, and it's kind of a fun plant to have in the garden. Now, something new that I'm growing this year is this pink banana squash. I mean, that thing is growing by leaps and bounds. It's a 100-year-old variety. It's an heirloom variety, and it is supposed to grow between 10 and 40 pounds. It's a winter squash, so we'll be harvesting it in the fall, and it'll be kind of fun to see how big that gets. I think that's the only one I have on that vine, so we'll see how it grows. Okay, here we are inside the red planter area. There's also a butternut squash that's trailing down in through the middle. And I'm just gonna kind of weave the butternut squash all around the planter because they can be real space hogs. But look, I've got a butternut right there. And there's a couple more coming on, I think, at the end of the vine. Now in the middle here, I've got two tomato plants. And these, again, are the Kellogg's Breakfast Tomato. Got these in late, I think maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago, or about 4 weeks ago. Growing strong. I've been out here shaking my cages, trying to pollinate those flowers to get some fruit coming on in this heat. So we're hoping for the best with that, hoping for a big harvest of Kellogg's breakfast in the fall. And then in the back here, this is the cucumber plant I just did the peppermint oil spray video on. And it's already looking better. I'm waiting for it to grow in a little bit more. I did give it some fertilizer, got some new growth coming on. I think a couple of the cucumbers are about ready to harvest. We'll be harvesting those later today. And really hoping for the best with this plant. I think it's gonna bounce back. Now over in here, I've got some mint. So I leave some of the mint flowers on. Now this plant goes crazy, can tend to be very invasive. So I have it here in one of the red containers. And it's probably about ready to be cut back and get some fresh new growth on here. But the mint is absolutely delicious. And one of my favorite summer drinks, mojitos. So maybe we'll make those tonight. Now I have had a lot of questions about these red planters. So let me just tell you the story on that. The red planters were actually once a galvanized steel pipe that we reclaimed from a local farmer, cut into pieces, painted, and then we put them in our garden to add some color, some interest, and some texture to this area. Now just to wrap up our garden tour, let me show you one last little area that I have up here on my wall. This is kind of my late summer planting area, but transplanting some vegetables up in here. Before we do that though, back in here is the blackberry patch. Now again, it's kind of a messy area of my garden. The blackberries are kind of sprawling. There's some weeds in here, but I'm getting blackberries for the first time this year. So excited about it. They are just so incredibly delicious. Here's one right here that is ready to pick. Oh my goodness, look at that. Wow, these are so, so good. Juicy, sweet, oh wow, so good. But let me tell you what plants I have going on right in here. This is actually a new one to me. It's a red racer tomato. The cool thing about this is it's a 2018 All-America Selections winner, which means that it's a very productive plant. It's been tested against plants of its same type, and this one came out a winner. So we'll be having a lot more about All-America Selections in the coming weeks. It's a determinate tomato. It's only supposed to get about 3 feet tall. Just planted it maybe 3 weeks ago. It came to me as a seedling. Already getting flowers. I should be able to harvest these 60 days from transplant to harvest. So we'll be harvesting these this fall. But in here, I have some of these new to me anyway, Smart Pots transplanters. And these are a lot of fun. I've got some cucumbers in them. And what these are is they've got a slit in the side so that when I get ready to transplant them into the garden or into a larger container, they're going to be super easy just to pull out and just pop right in. I hope you enjoyed seeing the garden from the ground. Now you get to see it from the air. Hope you enjoy the summer garden tour. Comment below, let me know what your favorite part is and how your summer garden is doing. Subscribe, share. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.